If you are thinking about applying for the Global Career Scholarship, the graduate version 2023, there are three important changes that have been made to the application guideline that you must take into account when applying for this scholarship. If not, you would fail. Hello everyone, welcome back to the channel, Daddy Cliff here. In today's video, I am going to point out three important changes that have been made to the application guideline for the Global Career Scholarship graduate version, that is for those who want to apply for a master's or PhD to come and study in South Korea. Now, before we get into the details, please, if you know you've not yet subscribed to the channel, why not hit that subscribe button, turn on the notification bell so that you will always be notified when there are new videos. Also, if you want to know more about the Global Career Scholarship, there is a playlist where you would find GKS graduate series. You would find a lot of videos here that I've made about the Global Career Scholarship. You might want to watch those videos. Also, if you go back to the playlist, there is this one, the GKS undergraduate series. If you click on it, there is one important video that I think you must watch it. That is 9 reasons as to why people fail their Global Career Scholarship. That is one video that has had a lot of views on this channel. You might want to watch it before you apply for the Global Career Scholarship. The first change that has been made is at the level of university track and embassy track. In the 2022 application guide, it was divided into first embassy track, and you had type A and type B universities. And then university track had general and regional university. But when you look at the 2023 application guideline, it has been brought down just to universities that are available, and then you would have type A and then type B universities, which means even if you are applying for embassy track, you would have to select your universities from both type A and then type B universities. If you are applying for university track, you would have to select from either type A or type B. Now let's look at the application. On the application, there is choice one. It says choose from type B. That means you must select at least one choice from type B universities. And then if you go to choice two, it says choose from type A or type B. That means you can either select from either type A universities or type B. And then choice number three says you should choose from either type A or type B. That equally means you can choose from either type A or type B, which means in the end, you would probably end with two type B universities and then one type A, or one type B and then two type A universities. That's how it's supposed to be. It is very important that you note that. It is no longer like in 2022 application guideline where you would have a section just for embassy track where you'd have type A and type B, and a section for university track where you would have general or regional universities. It is very important that you follow the application guide when applying for this scholarship. I think it is better for me to explain this by using an example. Let's say choice one, it says choose from type B. If you go to the type B section, you would find Andong National University. That will mean you would select a program from Andong National University. If you go now to choice number two, it says choose from either type A or type B. If you go to the application guideline, you would find the first university there. It's either Aju University or maybe Chung-an University or any other university. Let's say you decide to choose Aju University. It means you will choose a program from Aju University for choice number two. On choice number three, you still have an opportunity to either select from type A or type B. All right, let's say you decide to go for KAIST, Korea Institute of Science and Technology. If you select a program from KAIST, that will mean you have finally decided to choose one type B and then two type A's. But if you decide not to select KAIST for choice number three, and you decide to go maybe for Chung-an University, that is a type B university, that will mean you finally ended up selecting two type B. That is, choice number one is type B, choice number two is type A, and then choice number three is type B. That is to make it as simple as I can. Now, the second change that has been made is at the level of certificates, graduation certificate. Last year, the 2022 application guideline enabled people who had not yet graduated. For example, if you are expecting to graduate, maybe as of last year, you were expecting to graduate in August, maybe August 28, 2022, you were still able to apply pending graduation. In that case, you were supposed to provide a certificate of expected graduation or expecting graduation. That is to say that you would graduate in the near future. But if you go by the 2023 application guideline, you can only apply if you know that you would graduate in February 28, 2023. That is to say that anyone who would graduate maybe as of 1st March cannot apply for this scholarship. And also those who have already graduated, like let's say you graduated in January or you graduated this 10th of February, you can still apply. Or maybe you graduated last year, 2022, maybe you graduated in 2021, you can apply because you would have to supply a certificate that proves that you have graduated or a diploma that proves that you have already graduated. This year, as of 2023, let me repeat again, you can only apply with a certificate of graduation, a certificate that proves that you have already graduated. You cannot use a certificate of expecting graduation or a certificate of expected graduation. It is very important that you take that into account. You can only apply if you know that you will graduate by the 28th of February 2023. The third change is at the level of GPA or CGPA. Now, the Global Career Scholarship has stated the types of GPAs that they will take into account. The first one is on a scale of 4.0, on a scale of 4.3, on a scale of 4.5, on a scale of 5, and on a scale point of 100. That means if your university or your country of residence has a scale system that is maybe on a scale of 20 or any other thing that is not among the scales that I have listed or the GPAs that I have listed, it means you would have to look for a means to convert it. You will not only have to look for a means to convert it into the scales that have been or the GPAs that have been mentioned, you would equally have to provide proof from your university that they do recognize the conversion. Also, if you use something like Scholaria or maybe West.org, you would equally have to provide maybe a stamp in that document that shows that, okay, our university accepts the conversion from Scholaria or any other conversion system. You would have to take maybe a stamp. A stamp is supposed to be on that document. You're not supposed to do an apostille or maybe a consular confirmation of the document. You just need to provide a proof from your university or your high school, if it's at the level of high school graduation certificate, that this conversion is recognized by your university. They have to prove that they recognize it by putting a stamp on it and maybe a signature. It is important that you take into account those changes because it is very important. Remember, it is a scholarship and scholarships are meant to select those who are able to respect the rules of the scholarship, and they always look for those little mistakes to eliminate people, because it is very important for me to state here that the Global Career Scholarship is getting very popular, which means a lot of people are now applying for the Global Career Scholarship, so they would look for some of those little mistakes to eliminate you from the scholarship. That being said, I guess what I've said in this video is kind of useful to you who is planning on applying for the Global Career Scholarship. If that is the case, please make sure you hit that like button. And also, if you know you've not yet subscribed to the channel, why not hit that subscribe button? And I will see you in the next one. Bye.